Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and this just in. I got questions. I have lots of questions. Questions. So let's get right to it. Really happy that I reached 3,000 subscribers, or past 3,000 subscribers. I'm a little tired, so just forgive me, please. I'm a little tired. Hopefully this wakes me up a little bit. So, for those who don't know, I actually started my channel back in June of 2011. And so it took me 5 years, or just a little over 5 years, to get 3,000 subscribers. For some people, 3,000 subs is a lot. For others, it's like, you only have 3,000 subs. So, I don't know. I'm glad. I always take things on the positive side of things, and I think that that's a lot of subscribers. I could be more popular if I played more popular games, if I acted crazy, if... I don't know. Look at what a lot of the popular YouTubers do, and look what I don't do, and technically, yes, I could do those things, but, I'd rather just be myself, play the games I want to play, and act like myself, and not have to put on an act and such. So, yeah, 3,000 is good for doing it the way you want to do it. And, yeah, I cracked my thumb just now. I am happy, I am pleased. I know some people are going to be like, it's only 3,000. Yeah, for the amount of time I've been around, but I really started out playing some obscure games, and then in 2012... I played Skyrim, but also played obscure games still, besides Skyrim. So I kept that up, and I'm still playing. I'm playing a Sega Genesis game from 94, I believe. So yeah, I still play some obscure stuff. Anyway, so I am happy, and thanks to everyone who subscribed and who supports me, you know, and whatever way you support me, even just by watching the videos, you support me. Even if you don't say a thing. Because it's views, and it's minutes, time, you know, all that helps. So, on to the questions. The answer to the Patreon questions first. I had the Q&A video up for a few days on Patreon before I went live to everyone else. Corindist said, I asked, do you remember the first game you played, and if so, what was it? Do you still play it now? First game I've ever played, taking that to mean video game, would probably be, it's Combat on the Atari 2600. Specifically the tanks level. We went to Missouri to visit my grandfather's brother, which, I don't know, that makes him granduncle or something. And they had a lot of cool stuff. They had an Atari 2600. They had a Laserdisc player. I didn't know what any of this stuff was. I don't think my parents knew what it was either. But they were pretty cool. They had all the latest stuff. We ended up watching Psycho for the first time on Laserdisc. And they pretty much, it was down in their finished basement. They had all this stuff, and, you know, the rest of the time, I was just beating the pants off my brother in the tanks. For those who don't know the game, you start out, you know, you're both behind a little... You know, that's literally the way it is. You're in a little barrier, and you roll your tank out, and you have different options. My favorite one was with the ricocheting bullets, and I was really good at bouncing, ricocheting all my bullets off of everything, and hitting my brother, and the tank goes, awesome. First game. Meerkat. Do I still play it now? Oh, sorry. No, I have not. If I you know, had someone over to play it. Yeah, definitely on an emulator. But I haven't had that. That sounds like fun, actually. I think I want to do that with a friend who comes over. Sooner or later, should be over. Meerkat asked, have you ever played Dark Souls and will you ever play it on the channel? No and no. Reason being, I don't enjoy playing games that are punishingly difficult. What draws me into games is not challenge, but not really. Although I do admit some satisfaction when you pass a challenge. When you're able to, you know, beat a game. But yeah, what really gets me into the game is the characters and the story. And all that. So, not punishingly difficult, not dying over and over again. It's okay. I'd probably never be able to finish the game, and that would be upsetting, because I like to finish my games. Ryan Lewis asks, what is your favorite comic series? Hard to pick just one. But probably a cross between Dreadstar of the Marvel Epic line from the 80s and then went on to First Comics. And originally started with a series of short, serialized stories in a magazine called Epic Illustrated called The Metamorphosis Odyssey, which you can find in paperback now. And I only had a few Epic Illustrators. They're pretty hard to find unless you go on eBay or something. And it's about the destruction of the Milky Way. Pretty awesome. And that's basically, you know, where the prelude ends. Awesome series. Also really enjoy Amethyst from DC Comics, the old Amethyst, not the new one. Really, everyone named after gems. It was pretty awesome. And basically a regular, you know, average teenage girl who, once you're summoned to the gem world, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure after that she could go by, you know, of her own volition. She would then be in her 20s and gorgeous, and her name is Amethyst. So, and plus that's my favorite stone, so that you really started off on the right side. It was all, you know, swords and sorcery and everything like that. Awesome stuff. Shaggy775 asks, what was your least favorite game to LP? Probably the one I'm doing now, Star Trek The Next Generation, Echoes from the Past for Sega Genesis. That is punishingly difficult, to me at least. And of course there's no difficulty level, and yeah. Basically, if it wasn't for save states, I'd never be able to finish the game in the first place. I'd be a few hours in, and then it would be abandoned LP, and I'd probably be all pissed off about that and make all the videos private. But yeah, other than that, it would probably be the Postal 2 mod, Eternal Damnation, I believe it's called. And I played that after playing Postal 2, and then the Apocalypse Weekend DLC, and then went into that, and I was kind of sick of Postal-type stuff halfway through Eternal Damnation. And I just wanted it to end, and it went on longer than I thought it would. I thought it was going to be a short little game, and I don't know. Turned out to be, I don't think it was 20 hours, but I'm guessing it was like 15 hours or something like that. So I was like, wow. And it was basically the same thing over and over again. Run around and, you know, kill zombies. Bloom, bloom, bloom. So, The top one has to be now. I mean, I know it's happening right now, so people think, well, yeah, you're in the hell right now. But yeah, it's gotta be the hardest one, I think. I mean, it started off hard and got harder. I'm talking about Echoes in the Past now. So yeah, those games. And what suggestions would you give to someone starting to LP? That would be, well, do it for yourself. Do it because you enjoy it. Don't do it with the intention of making money off of it, because unless you're, I don't know, you have some meteoric rise or something like that, you're really not going to make enough to live off of, most probably. And, yeah. It won't be genuine. Yeah, be genuine. Upload often. You know, keep everything rolling, and I don't know, just be yourself and do it because you like to do it. And that's what I did for like about 2 years. I didn't get paid anything. I wasn't on a channel. Actually, it was 3 years. I did LPs for no money at all. It was only wait a second. No, it was 2 years. 2 years. 2013 I started up with Maker Studios and my channel in 2011, so it's just a little over 2 years. And I just did it, you know, because I enjoyed it. Playing games, comments, you know, all that stuff. It was great. Cool Damn Damn. And Lightning Mark, I believe is the name. Both asked me what is my favorite game. I will pick Planescape Torment. Greatest story ever in a game that I've ever seen. Epic in scope, and the most memorable characters, or some of the most memorable characters ever. I mean, who can forget a wizard that's on fire, like always? Modron, which is a little, what would you call him? Is their geometric shape. Their geometric shapes and follow from the plane of order they come from. So they follow order. And this one's a rogue Modron who shoots crossbow bolts that are sentient. And on top of that, a succubus who is devout, kind of like born again, like a demon that decided to become, you know, a born again Christian or something like that. Shiosa. And not only that, but the Nameless One himself, plus voiced by Dakan was voiced by Mitch Pileggi from X-Files, which is awesome. And John DeLancey. And there's a lot of great actors and actresses. Jennifer Hale. And, yeah. Anyway, that's why. In a nutshell. What is your favorite movie/TV show? Not sure if they mean movie and TV show, Cool Damn Damn, or just one or the other. So I'm going to choose TV show, and that would be Babylon 5. Again, greatest characters ever. Epic, you know, galaxy-altering story. Just, it doesn't get any better than that. And I love Mass Effect. And Mass Effect and Babylon 5 have a lot of similarities. Let's just say it that way. They're inspired, which is great, because anyone who's inspired by Babylon 5 and knows how to do, you know, use that inspiration to good use, they're going to come out with something awesome. So I know they're inspired by a variety of different things, but can't help but see some of the parallels in this story. So anyway, Skaze the Red, I'm saying that right, says burger or sausage. I'd have to say sausage. Get your mind out of the gutter with that answer. Mainly because I'm not a big fan of beef, but I do like bacon and sausage. And I'm not a big meat-eating person, which drives some friends of mine insane who are vegan or vegetarian, because they're like, well, you don't even like it that much. You could be vegetarian. And I'm like, yeah, but bacon, you know? Gotta have bacon, and I love seafood. So, yeah, that would be sausage, because it's pretty much the only thing I like barbecued, by the way, is sausage. No hot dogs. No hamburgers, steak, no. You'll never see me just eating a steak. It's just, no, no thanks. Mark Smith asked me a bunch of questions. I'm going to pick three to answer. One of his questions is asked later by somebody else as well, so I'm going to get into that then, so technically I'm answering four of your questions, Mark. So, are you going to do any live streams on YouTube Gaming or Twitch? That would be no, sorry. I'm really not into that. Maybe someday, but I don't know. It doesn't appeal to me. I like putting out videos. I just like this format, is basically what it is. So, I like editing and, you know, putting things out in a serialized format's pretty, I don't know. I've always liked it. And that's what started me on my channel. How many hours a day do you play games? Well, I don't play every day. I mean, there are some days when I'm just tired and I just go to bed. There are a lot of days where I just edit. And I really would like to play a game, but I'm just editing. So, and that's going to lead into the next question, but I'll get to that in a second. So it would be safe to say how many more hours a week, which would be probably between 7 to 10 a week. I'd say that. Yeah. How long does it take you to edit and upload game videos to YouTube? That varies widely, based on, well, do I have any edits to do? And how long does it take to render the video? Something like Mass Effect takes forever to render the video, takes forever to upload the video. I don't always stick around when I set to upload. I'll usually do that. I'll upload while I'm doing something else. So, there are some, like, smaller games, like the Genesis game that I'm playing now. I can actually play it while I upload something. But for Mass Effect, I wouldn't do that. I mean, it probably wouldn't make that much of a difference. But I just rather not take, you know, even a 3 frame per second hit, because I have Mozilla up with something uploading. Firefox. Anyway, so how long does it take me to edit? If it's like a JRPG, a lot of videos have random battles, and I fast forward those, because who wants to see me, you know, fight random goblins, you know, 10 times. So, in that case, I'm often playing the entire video back while removing those sections or putting them into, like, a speed-up kind of thing. So, if I play a half hour's worth of the game and then edit, and I'm actually watching for a half hour, but then I'm editing as well, which can add 5 to 10 minutes on. and then I have to save the video, wait for it to save. So that's an app. That's probably about an hour, you know, once you add in a rendering time, and then I have to upload it. So takes a while. And that's figuring I can get through that episode without having to stop, you know, without getting stuck, without having to look up like a walkthrough or something like that to keep going, or taking an inordinate amount of time to figure things out. That will add on time. You know, there are times when I will play ahead and just figure out what the hell I'm supposed to do and then go back and record, so it could take a while. But then again, there are some games where it's a straight record, and I just add a fade in, fade out, intro, outro, and boom, save, and I could be done in, like, I don't know, 30, 40 minutes, and then upload, walk away, or do something else. So, depending. Andrew, New Zealand asks, what was your first computer / console? Well, I'm going to answer not like mine, myself, but the first ones that I played games on, which technically they weren't mine, they belonged to the family. So, first console would be, like I said, Atari 2600. After we came back from Missouri, I'm pretty sure I harassed my parents endlessly about getting that, and then we got it, and my father played a lot, too, and I played against him, and he always beat me. So he would beat me on anything. His favorite game, I believe, was Pole Position. He got to a point where you basically, I don't know if this is true or not. I mean, it sure looked like it. You got to a point where you couldn't get any further in the game. Once you got to a certain clock, the car would just crash, and there was nothing there. He showed me once. It was a long time ago, though. But yeah, a little aside. First computer was a Tandy 1000 EX, on which we played excellent games such as King's Quest, Space Quest, submarine games, flight simulators, Starflight. Games such as that. Had the first couple Ultima games. Didn't get into them because they were very, very, I don't know. If you've ever seen the first couple Ultima games, they're very rudimentary. And I didn't see the point in it. There was no reward, really, for figuring things out. You just got to do, you know, keep doing more. What was your first RPG? Not completely sure. It was either the first Ultima game or Starflight. It's probably the first Ultima game. And I really didn't enjoy that. I mean, I got somewhat far, you know, but even back then, it was old. And we had Ultima 2 as well, and I started playing that, and I think it is improved in some areas, but where I had played, the limited amount I had played of it looked just the same almost, so I was like, no, I haven't finished the first one, is it just like the first one? So yeah, those are my first, and the first RPG, obviously I really enjoyed was Starflight. Loved that game, wasn't until many, many years later that I actually finished it. But I basically treated it like an open-world space exploration game, which is pretty much what it is. But it's got a story in it, and it's got RPG levelings and such, and inventory, all that kind of thing. Gamer Lon asks, what game do you hate the most? I'm not sure if I actually hate any game. I mean, there are some games that frustrate me playing them, and there are other games that which I really have no interest in. Horror games, I really enjoy the story, but they scare me too much. Real-time strategy isn't my thing. There are other games I'm just not into. like Minecraft, sports games, racing games are okay, and you know, can't think of there's any game I actually hate. Have you ever beaten a game overnight? The only one that comes to mind there is Battlefield 3. The campaign was 7 hours or 7 hours and change, and well, that was over a day, not really overnight. And I got to play that when I was back in Tucson and the family was away, and I had gotten the game some weeks prior and finally sat down to do an LP of it, and it was right after I finished Skyrim. So this is 2014 then, I believe, yeah. Battlefield 3, boom, done in 7 hours. What games will you not do a long play of? Okay, yeah, that comes back to the previous games I was listing. I have them written down here, actually. Minecraft, Mario games, Terraria, just because they're done to death, and I don't know, I really... I have no interest in those games, and playing those games. Real-time strategy games, racing, sports, no interest. Horror, interest, but too scared. So, yeah, those. Blah-erg asks, have you ever played Dragon Age Origins? Would you be interested in playing it? No, and yes, that's something that might be coming up. I wouldn't say next year, but possibly the year after. They're very long games, and I've been wanting to get to the Witcher series, and the Witcher series is shorter, for one. The games, except for maybe the last one. So I know Dragon Age, you can just keep going and going like Skyrim. But yeah, definitely interested in playing, well, the Dragon Age series in general, and that's something I hope to get to someday. Do you like two-player co-op games, or do you prefer single-player games? I prefer single-player games. I mean, I have played some co-op games. They can be fun, but yeah, I prefer single-player, really, over really any multiplayer. Co-op or PvP. Did you used to watch WWF? Did you have a favorite wrestler at the time? I watched casually. I mean, my brother used to watch it all the time, and I would watch with him, and these people were pretty in the 90s, or I think late 80s. They were pretty entertaining. Really didn't have a favorite wrestler at all. I mean, possibly Junkyard Dog, the Iron Sheik, and not because of anything, it's just their personality and the way they would act. And, you know, otherwise, if it wasn't on, I wouldn't turn it on. It was just if I happened to be passing by the room, or, you know, my brother had the remote and he wouldn't give it up, I'd sit there and watch it with him. But really didn't get into it. It was just funny to me. I actually used to have the wrestling album, which had a... I don't remember that song, but there's a video for it. It went na 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 na, with all the different wrestlers were saying different things, and they were basically not really singing, you know, just putting in different funny lines and stuff, and there was a whole album of that, you know. And Junkyard Dog had a song called Grab Those Cakes, and I like the song. Is that all you do? So, yeah, other than that, I was a fan of the album, really not so much as, you know, watching. But yeah, I've gone on and on about this, haven't I? 77 Arcturus asks, what is the scariest game you have ever played? Probably the first Silent Hill, which I did not get more than a half hour, 45 minutes into the whole part with the radio and the demons come flying and, or whatever the hell flies over to you, and I believe it's flying, and you hear, you know, you hear some kind of static or some kind of sound from the radio. That was very effective. That scared the hell out of me. And there was a part where I was running around in back alleys and got killed by zombies. Totally, you know, like, swamped with zombies. I was like, I can't do it. I can't play it. I want to, but it's just too scary. You know, and I'd watch someone else play it, you know, I wouldn't really, but I've never got around to that. So, yeah, it's probably the scariest game I've ever played, and that one bit with in the Vanishing of Ethan Carter where I screamed because I wasn't expecting, I mean, I was kind of expecting it because it was the environment, you know, down in Dark Mines for something like that to happen, but the whole entire game really didn't have anything like that until that point, so it surprised and scare the crap out of me. I hate jump scare stuff, and I hate, you know, creeping fear and something's coming to get me and run stuff, too. I just can't do it. It's just, I will watch horror movies. I will read horror books. I, you know, got into that stuff. You know, some of my favorite movies are the Hellraiser movies. And, you know, first 4 or 5, that's really it. But with games, it's interactive, and I get involved in it, and you have to run away from these things, and you have to get attacked by these things, and I get too into it, you know. I'd rather watch a scary movie or something. Noah Hill says, will you play some ESO, Elder Scrolls Online? So yeah, this goes back to the other question that Mark Smith was asking me about different... Well, he was asking me about a variety of MMORPGs. I do play EverQuest from time to time. I haven't played for a while because I got involved with No Man's Sky, and before that I was like basically trying to keep up with the two games a day that I've been putting out. Not so much as anything else than that, because those games can never end. They never do end. I mean, you can figure once you get to the highest level and get all the good gear, it ends, but then they add levels, and then they add gear, and new stuff for you to get, and new quests and stuff, so it really doesn't end, so it's like, not really, it's not good territory for me, because, number one, if I get into the game like how I used to get into EverQuest, which I'm surprised didn't happen, this time when I started putting up EverQuest videos, I didn't get hooked. I was afraid of that. I've had no problem just putting it down and doing other stuff. But if I get really into a game like World of Warcraft or Elder Scrolls Online or anything like that, I could start neglecting the channel because I just want to play that, and I don't want that to happen. So, I don't think anyone wants that to happen, so that's why no, and another reason it never ends, and another reason that I just, it's not the easiest thing to put commentary to, anyway. With EverQuest, I can put in a lot of commentary because I have so many memories of the game, and not only, even if I'm in a totally new place, I can still talk about, you know, some other similar place, or the other time, you know, the first time I went to this zone, which is completely unrelated, and I can just talk about it. So, that's the reason there with the EverQuest, so that's my one exception of, yeah, single-player games, as was asked before, so. Jack Kulk, hope I'm saying it right, what made you choose the name Amethyst Lunatari? Well, Amethyst is my favorite gemstone, and as well as, you know, the name of that comic book, which is more after the gemstone itself than the comic, and Lunatari is in the Dragonlance series of novels. There are 3 moons, Lunatari, Solinari, and Nutari. and they're all different. They're all different shades, and they correspond to three different gods, which there's more than three gods in that, you know, in that setting. But these three are, you know, they are pretty much the moons are not really them. They're manifestations of those gods. Luntari, Solinari, and Nutari. Do you plan on playing the other Elder Scrolls games? Okay, well, I just answered for Elder Scrolls Online, so take care of that. I'm hoping next year at some point I will play Arena. And I'm not sure, but I want to play Daggerfall. I'm not sure when I'd get to it, because somehow I want to fit Baldur's Gate and a whole bunch of other things in next year, and I'm not sure if I'll fit that either. Yeah, I need more time to do all this. Jack and Lord Larkin both asked, do you have any pets? If not, what pet would you get and why? Well, if not, because no, I don't have any. If yes, I would get either... I'd probably get a cat, just because they're easier to take care of. I do love iguanas and lizards in general, as well as birds. But my first choice would be a cat, but I don't have one because my landlady doesn't allow pets, even though she has two cats herself. So, yeah, otherwise I'd get one. I'd get a cat. I'd get a kitten and you know, enjoy kitten life and then watch the cat grow up and all that fun stuff. Someday I will. Have you or will you make a P.O. box or something so we could send in letters and such for you? I'm not really sure. I mean, if a lot of people wanted to, like, send me stuff like that, I probably would. It's just that the closest post office to me is 3 miles away, and I don't have a car. So it's a little difficult, so I'd have to either walk 6 miles or get on a bus and get out there. I'd still have to walk about a mile to the bus stop that would go in that direction. So, yeah, it would depend. It would greatly depend on whether a lot more than one person would mention it. So, other than that, you know, until then, no, that would probably be if I have a lot more subscribers, maybe, you know, 4 times as much as I do now, then, yeah, you know, if people would want to do so, I'd get a P.O. box. Lord Lorcan also asked, do you have a family? Well, yes. Grew up with a family and then made my own family twice. Basically cheated on or attempted to cheat on me twice. And so that fell apart. And that's it. But yeah, I have a family I grew up with and, you know, mom, dad, brother, sister around and stuff. So, favorite color is purple. Amethyst, gemstone, purple. Everything purple. I love purple. Spiritica Starbreeze asks, who is your favorite character that you've played in games and why? Off the top of my head, I can really only say Commander Shepard. Because Commander Shepard, freaking awesome. That would be the female Shepard, because that's the one I've played. The Nameless one is pretty awesome. From Planescape Torment. I think back to other games. In Skyrim, you make your own character, so... have your own personality. Same as with all the Elder Scrolls games. Yeah, that's all that really comes to mind. I'm sure if I look back at my games catalog, I'd come up with some more. Who is your favorite NPC in games and why? I'd say a toss between Liara in Mass Effect, and I'm going to split it three ways because I can't decide. Liara from Mass Effect, or Carlyle from my version of Skyrim. My modded version. See episode 400 of my Let's Play Skyrim for a wedding with Carlyle. And third would have to be Mort the Flying Skull from Planescape Torment. A honey nut tree or sweet roll? Not completely sure what the honey nut tree is. So I'd have to say, let me guess, someone stole your sweet roll. And Sam White asked just a few hours ago from this recording, what has been your favorite place or planet in the Mass Effect series? So actually I have a Mass Effect specific comment thrown in just in time. Favorite place would have to be the Citadel Station, whatever you choose to call it, from the first game. Underwhelmed in the second game, but the first, it was a place of wonder and awe, and I was just completely taken aback by this place. And I guess runner-up would be Omega from Mass Effect 2. Yeah. Best club ever. So, really enjoyed it going back there again and again for different missions, as well as the Citadel in the first one. So that's have been my answers, and this was a long video, and hope it wasn't too long for you guys, and thanks so much for all your support over the years, whether you've been here over the years or not, but thank you, really, for all the comments and likes and support. Yeah, really appreciate it all, and this makes it worth going. I mean, any ad revenue otherwise comes to me is secondary. Very helpful, very appreciated, but it's interacting with all you guys and doing all this, and this is like the job that I would love to have that wouldn't be like a job, but unfortunately, so it's like I really have two jobs. I have this job that's almost a volunteer when you compare it to my regular job, which is, you know, actually pays the rent. So I see this, I look at it as the responsibility of a job, but it's the fun of a hobby and connecting with all you guys that makes it really amazing. So thanks for everything. Thanks always. And enduring, grow strong.